So you're doing media planning for a YouTube campaign and you want the best results possible. You need to forecast how much of your audience that you can reach and for what budget and how that's going to compare to TV, for example. That's where the Reach Planner in Google Ads comes in. The Google Ads Reach Planner is an awesome campaign planning tool that is designed to accurately plan for reach-based video campaigns. And in this video, I'm going to show you how it works and I'm going to answer six of the most commonly asked questions about the tool. Hey everyone, I'm Richard Cruz. My agency tests and develops cutting-edge Google Ads strategy and YouTube ad strategy every single day. And in these videos, we share with you the best tips and the strategies that are actually working and how you can apply them to your own campaigns as well too. But before we get started, click on that subscribe button if you'd like to receive free Google Ad tips as we release these new trainings. The Reach Planner in Google Ads, it's an awesome tool. I love it. I like to think of it as a lab where you can experiment with different mixtures and you can get those projected outcomes that you want in your media campaigns. It's got the flexibility of just literally planning, you know, what that reach is going to be. You can build your forecast by changing like audience types, for example, by changing some of the demographics, geographies. You can use a different mix of ad formats in the overall budget, and you use all of that data to dial in your specific goals, because it should be your goals, who you're trying to reach, and what objectives that you're trying to reach. And so it really gives you, in my opinion, the most effective reach possible. And it's a really great tool to be able to determine that. Now, if you're not sure about the right mix of video ad types to use, no problem, we got you covered, because the Reach Planner in Google Ads also provides recommendations on the best ad types to match your goals specifically. And you can even measure your forecast against reach and frequency using industry standard matrix like gross rating points and cost per point. And so let me head over here to the actual tool here, and I'm going to cover with you the top six most frequently asked questions about the bell curve, because really all the data and the heart of this tool is right inside of this bell curve. So the first question that I get is, what is the reach curve? And so this reach curve, as you can see, as I bring this, you know, across here, each point on the curve, it's going to show you what budget that you're going to need for your goals, or vice versa. What could be your reach for a given budget, you know, for example. So when you're planning your campaign, you just hover over the curve to get the different scenarios for your reach and your budget ratios. You can even change the y-axis in the Google Ads Reach Planner to show you on target reach, absolute totals, or on target reach percentages. Let me show you that example right here. In this drop down right here, you're able to make that switch. And then this is just a little slider here. And as you slide, you're seeing all of the data be able to change. And then you can figure out where you want to be in that area. Number two, what is the maximum reach point? Well, the highest reach point on the curve, which you see right here, that highest point, it shows those dotted lines. That's the maximum reach point. And it shows the maximum number of people that the system is able to forecast based on the data that it's able to assimilate. Now, it's not the maximum reach of a YouTube audience. So if you budget beyond that point, you will get more frequency than you will actually get incremental reach. And if your goal isn't just too much frequency can start causing ad fatigue. So that really is an area that you want to just be careful with if you're going beyond that. Question number three, what is the effective frequency? And if you look right up here, the number that you choose from a 1 to a 10, on this drop down here, that signifies how many times you want your target audience to be exposed to your ad. The on target reach drop-down menu, it indicates the number of people that have seen the ad that number of times. And so the most efficient reach to set this at when you're going through the planning tool is 1+, unless you want to make sure that your videos get to see the video more often than that. Number 4 question is, what's the difference between +1 on target reach versus average frequency? And so if you look right here in this section here, changing the +1 on target reach, it's going to impact your media plan reach numbers, but the average frequency in your media plan, it's going to still be unchanged. Since it's always showing you the average frequency for a +1 on target reach, that's your minimum effective frequency. But look, remember that none of these metrics, they're going to impact your campaign settings. So you set your frequency cap inside of your actual campaign. Number 5 is right here. Why can't I see the reach percentage or the total population of the plan in this section right here? In the reach planner in Google Ads, the total population and reach percentage, they're removed if you're using non-demographic targeting layers. So for example, like parental status, affinities, or in market. So let's say, for example, the number of people in market for appliances, right? That is changing constantly. And so Google Ads highlights your absolute reach instead of your reach percentage of that population. And number 6 is right here. What is the difference between on-target CPM and total CPM? The on-target CPM, it shows the CPM for the demographics and the Google audience that you choose. But the total CPM, so let me change these right here, as you can see there, the total CPM, it's going to show you the CPM per your plan's total reach, not just within your target demographics. So let me give you an example. If you're targeting, say, for example, people outside of your chosen demographics, the models, they're not 100% precise due to the cases like, you know, users that are sharing devices, co-viewing, or just incorrect user information that's declared. And you can just click over here and be able to bring up demographics and then device information as well too. And that is my overview on the Google Ads Reach Planner. And I hope that you've learned at least one thing in this video. And if you did, do me a favor, leave that one thing in the comments below. If I can be of help in your marketing, call or message me at WSI Priority Media. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, share it, and subscribe so that you're alerted of future training videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye for now.